Well, you've probably heard it before, but I wanted to re-emphasize it in this video. Moringa needs to be planted in very well draining soil. If you have a heavy soil, clay-based soil, you are going to want to prepare your planting site by digging out the soil, adding in sand to increase drainage, and then planting in that site. If you're not sure about how well draining your soil has to be, there's a test you can take. Go to the website, healthyleaf.com, and under the blog section, search for soil drainage test, and you'll see a link there of a test you can do to see if your soil drains well enough or not. And so what happens if your soil is holding the water and gets saturated with water, that water surrounds the tap root and causes root rot within really a matter of days, and it kills the tree. Doesn't matter if it's just a small seedling or a very large tree, root rot has detrimental effects. So I wanted to show you up close what that looks like. And so if you look at that root, as I squeeze it between my fingers, you could really just see that the root turns to almost like foam, or really, for lack of a better word, the root goes to mush. And so this video is really just to re-emphasize the fact to take care and prepare your planting site appropriately. Might be fine maybe through a dry summer period, but if you have wet winters, you want to prepare your site so your tree can be healthy year-round. Again, thanks for watching, and if you'd like to order root stock to plant your moringa from, go to the website at healthyleaf.com, and you can order root stock there to get your moringa oleifera tree growing as fast as possible.